Good evening, all of you. Today we are going to start with rudimentary understanding of Python and how exactly we need to start the Python with IDEs. Let me give you an introduction. It's a 5 days webinar. Nothing to worry. Whatever we could able to do, we can do today. Then in subsequent days, we will be coming with the rest of the syllabi for a set syllabus for this 5 days webinar. I'm the presenter, Dr. Lakshmi. Starting with this, what software I'm working for? You can notice that Jupyter notebook. It says that I'm working with Jupyter notebook. So this is the idea we can start. This is the Jupyter notebook or whatever we are working with right now. So without Jupyter notebook, how we can work? The another question starts. So this Jupyter notebook, we need to install. It's a free installation software. I just come back 1 minute. The free installation software with Anaconda. We need to install Anaconda 3. This Anaconda 3 freely available for the installation for any of the programmer. Let me use this as heading. The moment heading means it's not coding. This Jupyter notebook arranged in the form of cells. A tiny code we can execute. We can see the output step by step. We can work. Python is termed as interpreter. The meaning of interpreter is one line at a time, it considers the high level language and translates that language into or your code, the user whomever writes the code, that will be translated into machine level language. So it works in terms of cells. If we can include cells whenever we want to write a code. So it works in the form of cell. So how to download is the first question. You need to download.
Sorry, ma'am. Sorry to interrupt actually. I think you not shared your screen.
Shared, sir. Already it's in the share mode. Resume presenting. Okay. Something it is.
Okay,
sir.
Resume presenting. 1 minute. Sorry. Same no. time, I like to request all students, please hold a, rough copy and pen. Whatever instruction giving by Dr. Lakshmi ma'am, please note it down. And if you're having any laptop, right, or desktop with you, please practice it.
Sir, right, ma'am? Is it visible, sir? Jupyter notebook with the blue color, Anaconda 3?
Yeah, Anaconda 3 visible.
Yes, exactly. This is what we need to discuss now. Then I just suggest you, if you have laptop, you can install Anaconda 3. You can work with this Jupyter notebook. If you don't have, you go to Google Collaboratory. You can work even with your mobile. Whenever you want to work with your mobile without any installation, you are not having gadget or you are unaware of installation, Google Collaboratory is the product of Google. I will demonstrate subsequently after the introduction of Python. So nothing to worry about. You no need to install even though you don't have laptop, nothing to worry. This Google Collaboratory is a kind of IDE. What is IDE? First, let me start with that. IDE is Integrated Development Environment. We need to have any one environment for developing a program. Name it C, C++. Whatever the language we are trying to do, we need to have one environment. So this Integrated
Development. Ma'am, one small request, please, if you don't mind.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Actually, some voice is coming. So you please speak loudly and slowly. Actually, our accents are something different. And these are second year, third year students, they are not able to catch properly. So slowly from now.
Let us see the strength of today. If possible, we will move on to Zoom tomorrow also.
Sure.
Yeah, I'm raising my level best, the voice. Let me try. Otherwise, I may need to come very closer. Then that face would become very zoomified. So now, is it optimum? My voice is optimum?
Yes, ma'am.
Because I'm speaking
Speak
through
slowly loudly. And loudly. Slowly and loudly.
Yeah. Okay, fine. Fantastic. Understood. Yeah. If you have laptop, it is always advised to download Anaconda 3, not hash. This hash is for the purpose of this Jupyter notebook coding. I have marked. The moment if it is marked hash, and if I there are four options, code, markdown, raw NB convert, heading. So if I want to make this title as a heading, then I need to use heading. So because of this heading only, this hash has come. Otherwise, you need to download the software Anaconda 3. This Anaconda 3, if you just type in the Google, it is free to download by any programmer. So number one, suppose you don't have mobile, you don't have laptop, you are not in the position to download also, you feel very difficult to download, whatsoever may be the reason, you can use one more IDE, Integrated Development Environment, you can use one more, that is called Google Colaboratory. If you have Google account, that is more than enough. You just type Google Colaboratory in the Google, then it will take you. You may need to log in with your Google account or ac.in account or edu.in account, institutional account. Those two accounts are also Google product, ac.in, edu.in. These are all provided by Google for the academic fraternity to be used freely. So if you have any of the Gmail account or edu.in or ac.in, you may need to log in with your Gmail in normal. How you look into your mails, the same way you need to log in. Then simultaneously open a new tab and go to Google search engine, type Anaconda 3, then it will take you to the home page of Anaconda 3. There you can see the download button, you can use download, it will come. So this is one method. Second method is you can use Google Colaboratory. You can type Google Colaboratory, then whatever the home page it comes, you open it. Google Core Laboratory also will look like Jupyter Notebook. Same like structure, cell structure, one cell at a time. Each and every cell, we can code what we want to code. So these are all the two methods I can advise those who don't have laptop, those who are all finding difficulty in installing Anaconda 3. Number one step, if you wish, you can download and go and work with Google Colaboratory. Google Colaboratory is byproduct. I'll show you a demo also at the end of the session. I'll show you how to go with Google Colaboratory. That Google Colaboratory will support you Python programming, data analytics, artificial intelligence, deep learning projects or programs. Then subsequently, the same it will support for R programming also. So this is the message I wanted to convey. Number one. First, we should know how to work with. So this Jupyter Notebook, it has several menu. If you look at file, new notebook. If I want to open a new, fresh notebook, I need to use file and new notebook, Python 3. If I want to open existing notebook from the downloaded folder or any part of my machine, then I can use open. Make a copy. The same notebook, I can create one more copy. See, right now I have kept BVR80 day one. If I want to make a copy, I can save it as Synergy instead of technology day one. So that is possible. Rename is also possible. Save us. We can save wherever we want. Save and checkpoint. Whichever is not completed, you can put save and checkpoint. Revert to checkpoint. You can come back. Nothing to worry of these all. Just I am giving download us. We need to know how to create a new notebook. We need to know how to open the existing notebook. What is the meaning of opening existing notebook is? Someone will, suppose I myself will send this notebook, Jupyter notebook. This Jupyter notebook, if you want to open, you need to open using this button. You need to download, then you can open. Automatically, it will be there on your machine. Similarly, the same Jupyter notebook, you can upload in your Google Drive and you can open in the Google Colaboratory. Then immediately with my code and whatever I did, you can continue. Next, what you need to know is download. This Jupyter Notebook Colaboratory, whatever we are doing, it will have the extension IPYNV. Normally, when you write a program, any file, name it, even if you are watching movie, in a computer world, it has file extension. .mp4 you will have. Without MP4, you can't play a music, you can't play a video. Similarly, in order to indicate which program we are working, that IPYNV, that is the extension for Jupyter Notebook as well as Google Colaboratory. For both of the product or both of the IDE, we need to use the extension .pynv. If we are creating new file, we no need to keep. Automatically, IPYNV will be created. If we are uploading somebody's file, then we should be very careful. Voice is okay. IPONB is mandatory. Professor Ramesh, still people are telling voice is low. I have raised my voice to the level best. Beyond that, it is not possible. Maybe we need to change Zoom or something else.
It's okay, ma'am. Let's continue. Next class, we'll continue with Zoom.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
You please speak slowly. Actually, our accent is something different, pronunciation something different,
okay.
Right? So, okay. Kindly take care of that.
Okay. So, right now, how to work Python program, where to work Python program, that software regarding, IDE regarding only, I was addressing. If you have laptop, you can download this, those who have laptop. If you have mobile, both mobile also, laptop also, it supports this. Google Collaboratory is supported both by mobile and laptop. Nothing to install. This one for installation. We need to install. This one we need to install. Whereas this one, it is online available, online, no need to install.
That's interesting. Actually, you are speaking and writing.
Yes, thank you. This thing no need to install. This is the two major steps we may need to understand. This require installation. This doesn't require installation. Now let us see. This file we started. New notebook, open notebook, make a copy, savers and download. Finally, if I want to send to someone, then I need to download this notebook. So these are all the few features we need to know, nothing more. Then edit. This is for cutting the cell, cut cell, copy cell, paste above, paste below, paste cell and replace, delete cell. This cell, see, for example, I'm going to insert above one cell. This is called a cell. One row is termed as cell. Now I can delete, edit, delete cell, deleted. So it is check your end is audible only. Yeah. Insert above. So now view is for what? Toggle header, toggle toolbar, cell toolbar. Within that, if you wish, you can use these all attachments you can bring, slideshow you can bring. So these are all the possibility. You want to give presentation and do the coding, then view is required. Otherwise, for coders, it's not required. Now, the first cell, if I am going to make it as header, like this Anaconda laptop, this all, I want to write this all. If I want to write this all, then I need to select this cell, go here, you need to change it to markdown. If you change it to markdown, only then it is possible to write something other than coding. The moment I type markdown, see, I'm executing. How I am executing is I need to press shift enter. Shift enter, or you can press this run button. I'll tell once again, see, insert above, press shift plus enter, or press run button. This is how you need to run the cell. Now, look at that. This is error. It will indicate error because this cell is chosen as code. I need to change this as markdown or heading. If you look at now, it is becoming a text. If you want to annotate something, annotation means explain something, then you need to put that cell as markdown or you need to put that cell as heading. These are all the options. Now, second cell, we discussed about IDE. Third cell, it is there. See, markdown. This markdown means we can write something as a text. Now, presenter, this cell is also markdown. Now, my image has come. How I have done image, I'll show you. See, this is the code. This is HTML code. This HTML code, what I am trying to do is, this is not Python. I wanted to present like this. Going back with the PPT like that, without that I want to do everything in a notebook itself. So that I have brought HTML code, then I changed it as markdown, I placed my photo, I labeled my photo as lakshmi.png photo I copied where this Jupyter notebook is installed. The path, the same location I have copied. Then I need to use the code SRC. SRC stands for source. IMG, it is a HTML tag. HTML is a scripting language useful for website development or mobile app development. It's for web applications. So IMG is a HTML code I am using. Share your screen. What is happening? I shared now. Quite often it is disconnecting. Quite often that screen is disconnecting. Yeah, IMG is the HTML code. SRC is the source. That source is lakshmi.png. What is the width I want to display size of my photo? Height, display size of my photo. These are not record for you guys. If you want, if at all you want to decorate your Jupyter notebook relevant to your theme, drone, one drone picture you want to keep in the beginning so that your presentation would look relevant to that. By the time it is useful, you can use this code. See, if I click back my photo, I will be getting back that HTML code. If I run the cell, it will display my photo. That's it. So this is for decorating your Jupyter notebook, nothing more. Now let us move on to introduction to Python. Python is the language created by Guru Von Rossum. Released in 1991. Guru Von Rossum did his graduation both in mathematics and he did his graduation in computer science as well. He is the person released the first version of Python. He made it as open source. So many community, many people contributed to Python. The present version of Python, what we are using, almost it reached 3.8 version. Whenever we speak about language, we used to know which version we are using. The meaning of version is the revision or upgradation happened with the previous release. See, again it has gone. Yeah, previous release. So that is called version. He is the person contributed the language Python to all of us. Now, Python is a general purpose language. What is the meaning? We can write matrix division or subtraction, simple logical program, whatever we think a logic, Fibonacci series, factorial, any kind of general programming it is possible to do. That is a meaning called general purpose programming. Then dynamic language, it is useful for web application. It is useful for anything dynamically changing the scenario. IoT application, dynamically changing, drone application, robotic application, these things are dynamic in nature. It suits for dynamic. It's a high-level language. The moment any of the computer programming language resembles like English, like an English, it is termed as high-level language. Interpreted programming. What is the interpreted programming is, machine or the compiler, moment the user writes a program, it will consider one line at a time. Anything we communicate with the machine needs to be translated into machine level language. Even if you want to watch a movie, if you want to listen music, that needs to be translated into machine level coding. Only then machine can understand, can display the movie, can release a signal, audio signal or video signal. Similarly, when we write a program, that program need to be translated into machine level language for the computation. Even if we try to write a simple program A plus B, that needs to be converted into machine level language. In order to do that, either we use compiler or we use interpreter. There are two software. What is the meaning of compiler? It will take the whole of your program and translates high level language to machine level language. Whereas interpreter, it takes one line at a time and translates that high-level language to low-level language. That is why Python is termed as interpreted programming language, multi-paradigm language, object-oriented programming approach. Almost it's more powerful, I can say. Nothing to worry of this all. Now, this is what python.org. If you want to run a simple Python program, you can download Python with the latest version with this website, python.org. The meaning of multi-paradigm is, it is a functional program. it supports lot of predefined function. That is the meaning of functional programming. Structured programming, it has a structure, the way in which how to write a program, it is being defined already. Every one of us may need to use, we need to adhere that structure. Then modular programming, it supports for component level, modular level programming, and it is object oriented programming. This may be very new to you, object oriented programming. It is a concept called object and classes. Every scenario will be created in terms of class. Within a class, set of objects will be created. For example, a simple mechanical A section we used to call. It's a class name. Within mechanical A section, who are all the objects? The objects are every individual, every student of that particular section. You may be 60 students, or you are all maybe 65 count. You are all maybe 70 in count. That every one of you will become object of the class mechanical A. Now, Python language is to develop different types of applications, scientific application, standalone application, drone application, gamification, developing games like Go game, Focus, and PUBG. So many games you are all familiar. So it's possible to develop games and web applications. So many applications we can do, drone applications and robotic application. Drones and robotic and embedded logic, you can build this all. Now, what are all the features? It is easy to understand, elegant, syntax is elegant than compared to other languages. You will enjoy. We are not yet even started Python. It's in the theory or introduction section. Now, Python supports object-oriented feature, which are all in terms of classes, objects, and inheritance. These are all the concepts. Nothing to worry of these all. This much you need to, the theory concept, this much you need to learn. Directly we can learn the syntax and what context we need to use, how we need to use. That's enough. Python code is expressive language. What is the meaning? It will look like human language. For example, if you say the word a matrix addition, almost the matrix addition will look like that. Looking at the syntax itself, you can able to understand this is meant for matrix addition. If you are telling matrix multiplication, by looking at the syntax of the Python program itself, you can able to understand this is a syntax meant for matrix multiplication. That is the beauty of Python. It's an expressive language. Subsequent to that, platform independent. What is the meaning of platform independent is, if you develop a program for Linux machine, the same program you can make it to be compiled or interpreted or executed in the Windows machine also, Apple machine. So these iOS operating system, Android operating system, Linux operating system, and Windows operating system, all operating system that supports, that is said to be platform independent. You can write a code with any platform. Subsequently, you can deploy, install that software in any other operating system or platform. Any moment, if you look at the platform, most of the time that signifies operating system. At time, it signifies different contexts. Now, Python is case sensitive. Case sensitive when it comes is, whenever the variables are declared, every variable, what we declare in different combination would become different variable. For example, int age, I'm declaring age as a variable. Subsequently, I'm declaring capital AGE. The first AGE is different from capital AGE because one letter has been changed. Instead of small a, now we are starting with the capital A. Now I am writing completely AGE, all capital. Now this is different. Even a tiny letter is changed, every variable will become different in nature. You can make use of, although it look like age repeatedly, with respect to computer programming, each and every variable need to be treated as different. Age, different. Now, identifiers can be of any length. What is the meaning of identifier is, whenever user is permitted to coin something in the program. Only name of the function, name of the variable, name of the constants. These are all the three things always permitted by the user. These three are together said to be variable, comma, function name, comma, constant name. These three are permitted or given freedom to the user or the programmer. They can coin their own name. Instead of age, you can keep your name also. As a variable, as a function name, you can keep your name also. You can keep contacts, relevant name also, like addition, subtraction, multiplication, like that, anything you can keep. So whenever users are permitted to keep the name by themselves, in the programming convention, it's termed as identifiers. Next, indentation. Right from this point onwards, please pay your attention. This moment onwards, the momentum to learn Python is started. So please say with me, if you are full of attention. So this is case-sensitive language. Every identifier, the moment we change one symbol at least, it becomes a unique. It's a unique embodiment of the program. Identifiers, the moment we use identifier, when we can use identifier is variable, function name, constant name. Whenever users are given the freedom for coining their naming convention, it is called identifier. Now, indentation. What is the indentation is? This is more important when it comes to Python programming. I will show you for indentation. One instance I will show and I come back to that level. See, this is example for exact example for indentation. Look at for statement. For is for looping. Looping means whichever the statement comes under the control of that looping statement could be repeated again and again. It is possible to repeat again and again. Now, in order to indicate this print statement is working under the control of for statement, it is termed as indentation. Minimum 4-space indentation is expected by Python programmer. Anything under the control of something. So one function definition is there. Writing function in Python. See, if under there is a for statement, within that for statement, we are writing if statement. So for indent, look at before if I have given 4-space. Within if, again, we are writing print, then another 4, totally 8 indentation. Then else statement. Now, what is the meaning of if and else is? The power of execution is same. Now, which statement is under the control of for if and else? Else is not under the control of if. Else is under the control of for. Then else, 4 indentation additional, total 8 indentation. This creating space and structure is called indentation. Structure of the construct, space and structure of the construct is called indentation. I'll come back. I'll write here indentation. Space and programming construct is called indentation. Now, all the lines, whenever you try to write a program coding, that end of the line, maximum 79. If you are not able to complete your logic within 79 character, you need to continue with backslash. What is the backslash? This slash. The line is not at all completed. Beyond 79 characters, you are thinking the coding. You have that much bigger line of coding. Then you need to continue with backslash. Wherever it sees backslash, it will treat it as continuation of the previous one. Next. For example, long, multiple with statements cannot use implicit continuation. It will, the moment you press the enter, your interpreter cannot able to understand. Your IDE cannot able to understand. You need to mention the backslash. That's all. Now, how we can create variables or identifiers? Camel case, snake case, Pascal case. If you come to Python, most of the time you will see the name of the Python, Anaconda, snake, these are all repeating. Why that has come? There is an interesting story. Just go and read. Why it is python? Why it is snake? Why it is anaconda? All the family of snake name will be kept throughout the python. So that is why I am repeating snake case also. Nothing to worry of that. So there are three cases. What is the meaning of camel case? Any identifier we start with a capital word, capitalized word. See one example. I have written capital H. This is example for camel case. Capital complete H is also example for camel case, because these are all the identifiers starts with the capital. So it is called camel case. Subsequently, we are writing, we are moving, stepping into snake case. When you can say snake case, underscore, whenever you use underscore, it becomes snake case. The same age I am going to change it as make underscore students underscore age. I want to gather all of your age. For that I am creating one variable. Then I must create with underscore. The moment I use underscore, it is termed as snake case. Next, we are going for Pascal case. Pascal case, how it will look is, it will start with every word the same, make students age. Then I need to write like this. Capital make, students capital S, then capital age. This is called Pascal case. It permits three types. That's it. Then Python has no concept called private variable. It is called object-oriented paradigm approach. You no need to worry of right now that. Let me skip that portion temporarily. Then keywords. What is the meaning of keyword? It has predefined meaning. I say Pani is the word. It is meant for representing water. Instead of that, if I try to say this object, this speaker is Pani, you all will laugh at me. You will think that I am mad. This is my speaker. External attached speaker. I'm telling this is my Pani. Then immediately what you will think? You will think I'm something mad. So because Pani is keyword, it is predefined, reserved. The meaning and the syntax and everything is already predefined, that Pani. The moment I say the same word for Pani for someone, you will laugh at me. It is equivalent to that. In every programming language, there are certain words, reserved words or keywords that are all cannot be changed in different notion or different representation. We need to learn those keywords. What is its purpose? What is its syntax? In that context alone, we need to use it. We cannot change the predefined meaning and usage of those words. Pani is the word reserved in Hindi. Never I can think of changing that word. So that is called reserved word. So every keyword available in Python, starting with lowercase. Lowercase means small letter, A to Z small letter. Uppercase means capital letters, that's all. Except two keywords, true and false. These are all the only two keywords available with capitalized letter. Rest all the keywords available only with a small letter. These are all basic foundation, nothing to worry about if you don't understand these all also. But this is the conventional procedure. I need to start with some introduction about Python. That is what the way I need to say. Now, how to assign values? Assigning values, normally A is equal to 10. Even we write on a notebook, A is equal to 10, B is equal to 20, we will write on notebook also. That is called assigning. We are assigning RHS to LHS. That is the meaning of assignment. We are assigning something. Here, Python, the beauty is it permits multiple assignments. What is the meaning? Look at this. A comma B comma C. Three variables I have created. For all the three variables, in a single line, I am trying to assign values. 1000, 2000, 3000. Now, respectively, result I am trying to calculate A plus B into C. Then I can obtain the result. This is not the answer. Earlier it was different. Now that is the meaning of, or that is the power of Python. It allows multiple variable assignment. That is fine. Now, then I will move on to coding. Now we need to know every language has set of operators, arithmetic operators that all basic, plus, minus, multiplication, division, exponentiation. These are all the few operator or modulo operator. I will come to you what is modulo. Then relational operator, comparing. Roll number 1 is having lesser than roll number B mark. Roll number 1 is having less than or equal to roll number 2 mark. Roll number 1 is greater than roll number 2 marks. Something like that. Comparing, relating. Roll number 1 have obtained equal to roll number 2 marks. Both of their marks are same. Roll number A's mark is much better than roll number B's mark. Much lower than roll number 2's mark. Something like that. So that relativity. Relativity means less than or equal to, greater than or equal to, not equal to, equal to. There are six relational operators exist in almost all the computer programming language. Arithmetic, relational I said. Next, logical and or not. Combining more than one condition is called logical operator. Bitwise operator, special operator. These are all the set of operators we need to look at. Why we are talking about operator? Without operator, we may not be able to perform most of the operations. We are relying on computer only for the purpose of computation, operations. So we must know the minimum idea about, we must have about operators. Now, we are going to look at one rule, PEMDAS rule. This is much more important than whatever I covered so far now. Please pay your attention. PEMDAS rule. What is the meaning of PEMDAS? P stands for parenthesis, E stands for exponentiation, B stands for division, M stands for multiplication, A stands for addition, S stands for subtraction. This is only for arithmetic operator, PEMDAS rule. Why we need to learn PEMDAS rule? I'll just try to give a scenario, then you can able to understand what I'm trying to tell. See, A is equal to x into y plus, or not even this, 2 into 3 plus 5. Look at this, 2 into 3 plus 5. What is the mean? What would be the answer? Tell me. Any one of you, please text your answer in the chat box. I want to see your answer. 2 into 3 plus 5. Could you give me the answer? 11. Someone is telling 11. Then how do you get 4 plus 5? 4 plus 5, you are giving 10. That's fine. I was expecting different kind of answers. But luckily, everyone is giving 11 as an answer. What is the meaning is, you all are trying to compute this 2 into 3 first. After computing multiplication, you all wanted to add 5. But there is another scenario. Someone can think like this. Why can't you do 3 plus 5 into 8, 8 into 2, 16? It is possible, no? Could you get my point? That is called non-deterministic situation. Non-determinism occurs. You can compute. You can end up with answer either 11 or you can end up with answer 16. How that 11 you have obtained? In order to obtain that 11, you would have computed 2 into 3 first. Subsequently, that result you would have added with 5. This is this. Earlier one, step number one, the later one, step number two. I am questioning you, why you are not doing 3 plus 5 first, subsequently, why you are not doing multiplication with 2? Is the question. If you do, yeah, PEMDAS rule. If you do that, it is wrong answer. In order to fix this non-deterministic situation only, that PEMDAS rule. So, what that PEMDAS rule says is, first, whichever comes in the expression with the parenthesis, that need to be considered. If there is no parenthesis, next priority should go to exponentiation. If there is no exponentiation, we need to go to division. If there is no division, we need to go to multiplication. That's all. I think. Share your screen. Once again. Yeah. Quite often the presentation is stopped. I don't know. Okay. I'm handling two gadgets, sir. That is a problem. Okay. This is what I think, hope everybody understood PEMDAS rule. Most of you tried answering. Now let us move on to another concept. This is called precedence. Whom I need to give higher importance. For example, in the institution, in the corridor, principal, HOD, my own friend, 3 years standing in the corridor. To whom I need to greet first? I need to say good evening, sir. To whom I need to say? Naturally, I need to first greet my principal, because he is the power of high, apex power of execution, power of the institution. I need to give first respect, first greeting to principal. Subsequently, I need to greet my HOD. Later on, I can greet my friend either saying hi or good evening, whatever. So that is called precedence. Now precedence is over. Next question. Another scenario I'm going to bring. See, A, for example, 3 into 2 into 3 into 5, if not minus, all are of same operator or equal precedence. If it is equal precedence, in which order we need to evaluate? So that is the question will come. All the operators are of equal in nature. Then the concept is called associativity. If the precedence of the several operators are same, then we need to move on to the concept called associativity. What is associativity? Let me tell you. Associativity. For example, now I take another scenario. There are three of your teachers presently who are handling your subjects. All the three teachers, maybe maths teacher, physics teacher, chemistry teacher, English teacher. All four members are standing in the corridor. You need to go and greet them. How do you greet? If you pick a faculty and say, hi Lakshmi ma'am, good morning, then other three of them will think that, oh guy, this guy is having bias with Lakshmi ma'am, let me look into my laboratory. Some kind of negative thinking will happen. By that time, how you need to? Otherwise, imagine another scenario. You are going to interview. In the interview panel, there are two female interviewees and three female interviewees are there. How you will greet? Would you pick up a male and a female particularly and you will greet them? Not at all. You need to use the order. Either left to right, you need to greet them, or right to left, you need to greet them. That shows you are neutral to everyone. You respect each and everyone. You are having some logic. That is called associativity. Left associativity, right associativity available when it comes to computer programming language. Left or right. Each and every operator will have different associativity that we need to learn. We need to look at the table. We need to learn by looking at the book or internet material. Every operator will have different associativity. Left associativity or right associativity. That's it. Now, we move to when the associativity will come. Please remember, if all the available operators are of same precedence, then we need to apply associativity in order to fix the unique answer need to be obtained after the computation. Every one of us tries to get different answer. There is fuzzy situation. We need to get same answer whenever we execute with myself itself. Or anyone tries to execute my code, taking my code and trying and executing, it should become unique. So that is why they are using PEMDAS rule and associativity. Now, there are other IDE. Atom is available. Spider is another software. Spider will come part of Anaconda. PyCharm is another IDE. Jupyter Notebook is another way to use IDE or executive of program. That's it. Now, we are coming to introduction to Python. Now only we are going to start with practical or hands-on. Single line comment, multi-line comment. What is the meaning of comment? Comment is for the user. Whenever I revisit back my notebook, I should be able to understand. Always writing a program with a commentary line is appreciated and welcome. Why? Even if you take up a job, you will be doing a project, you will be doing a program. You may quit the company. That code is going to be that is a property of their own concern. Then somebody else is going to be substituted in the program. How that guy will be able to understand in what logic you are writing, in what sequence you are writing, what are all the commands you are using, that in order to fix this issue, internationally, this comment line is welcomed and it is emphasized to use comments. Whenever we write a program, we need to start with comment then and there. regarding to the context, it is the best practice of writing a programming is as much as possible introducing the commentary lines. That commentary line has two types. One is single line comment, another one is multi line comment. The meaning of single line comment is you are permitted to comment in a single line. The meaning of multi line comment is you are permitted to write a paragraph. You can give articulation, a tremendous articulation, a larger articulation. That is called multi line comment. Now let us see in Python how to write single line comment and how to write multi line comment. Multi line comment is not supported by Python, but rather we are going to use different concept. I'll tell that one. See, every commentary line need to be started with a hash. The moment we are writing commentary line with a hash, that will be ignored by the Python interpreter or compiler. No more the respect is given for that line. It is meant for external world users. I'm writing a code. You need to understand why I'm writing, how I'm writing, in order to understand the program by the human, interpretation by the human only, we are writing comment. See, now you would have understood why I use this hash so many times. This is commentary line, not at all a code. Then this is commentary line, not at all a code. Anything which I start with hash, that those all are termed as commentary line. Now, how to write a multiple commentary line? Triple quotation. You need to start with a triple quotation. You can write a big story also, big narration. You should end with triple quotation. But you should not say in the interview, this is multi-line comment. It is called string literal. We are trying to assign to some variable. Left-hand side, we haven't given the variable so that it is available with a triple quotation alone. Because of the triple quotation, it will treat it as multi-line comment. We haven't assigned this value to the left-hand side. What is the assignment means? A is equal to 10. That 10 is numerical constant. This is called string constant, string literal. Left-hand side, I haven't assigned to any variable. Because of that, it becomes a commentary line. Compiler just ignores. This guy didn't complete this line properly. So let me not bother that line like that. It ignores. Just because of that ignore option, it is treated as multi-line comment. Now, variable name can start with A to Z. Always it should start with A. Every variable should start with alphabet. Subsequently, it can repeat with alphabet or numerical. Now, let us come back to the first coding. Say, I am going to give age, name, city. 43 is my age. My name is Lakshmi. Where I am living is Hyderabad. So this is multi assignment, multiple value assignment with different data type. That is the beauty. Number one, you no need to worry about data type when you come to Python. If you say A is equal to 10, no delimiter also. No need to put semicolon, nothing. A is equal to 10. Then A is the object automatically created by the Python interpreter assigning the value 10. By seeing the value, A will take in the metamorphism called integer. The moment 10 is assigned, it will become integer data type. A is termed as object. It will become integer object. If I put dot 10.68, the moment I use 10.68, A will become float data type. Hope you will understand. A will become float data type. If I give A is equal to single quotation, yes, something like yes, or double quotation. I can use either single quotation or double quotation. A will become character data type. That is the power of Python. If I start writing Lakshmi, A is equal to Lakshmi, A will receive the value Lakshmi, it will become string data type. The object A will become string immediately. Now you can understand what I'm trying to tell. Now 43 will become integer object, name will become string object, city will become string object. This is what, now I'm printing age, it prints properly. 1-to-1 mapping, 1-to-1, 2-to-2, 3-3-3. Then name I am, I need to just type the, enter the name of the variable and enter, shift enter. See, I need to first execute this. I'm executing this. Next time executing, no error safe. Now see, because I haven't assigned. This is over. Now how to know the type? See, insert cell below. Type of age. Integer, it is telling integer. I haven't mentioned about integer in my program at all. That is a very prime beauty of Python. We don't need to crack our head. Declaration, initialization, mentioning the data type. These are all the headache not available with Python. Insert below. So here, I'm keeping here. Insert below. Now I'm going to give type of name. Enter. STR. I said now it will become string object. STR. If I try to give, if I want to know type of that particular object, I need to use the function called type. Then I need to pass the variable name. The third variable is what? City. If I want to know city, what it would become? Can you say anyone? Data type of city? Type of city. String, exactly. Thank you. Type of city will become str, string data type. But you are assigning 43 to city? No. Order 1 to 1, 2 to 2, 3 to 3. Someone asking this question. Please, sir, I am revisiting that. The same order. See, age I declared first. Name I declared second. City I declared third. Then I need to give in the same order the values also. The age I am assigning 43. Name I am assigning Lakshmi. City I am assigning Adam. That's it. Yeah, thank you. Now we are going to look at arithmetic operator. Two same values in different variables. Yeah, I will show you. Exciting. Now I will show you that. Insert below. I am going to give A, B, C is equal to 25. Now tell me what is the value of A, B, C? It is possible. Subrat Kumar? Yeah, all are 25. That's it. Enter. Why it is not coming? Yeah, I should not give equal to, comma I should not give, equal to equal. This is how I, no comma, comma is not, correct. The moment I use comma, I should give multiple values. A, I need to give 25, once again I need to give 25, B 25, C 25. Now I am going to display A. See, it displays B. Comma is not permitted, equal to equal to equal to. Assigning, Subrat Kumar asked, how can I assign same value to multiple variables? Then this is the only way. Now I'm going to insert below. I'm going to display B value. It gives me 25. Insert below. I'm going to give C value. See, this cell had gone here. I need to delete. I need to delete. Yeah. Now B, insert below C. That's it. Got it? Now, we are moving on. With this, we wind up. Almost we are reaching 6 o'clock. Addition, arithmetic operator. Plus, minus, star, division. Modulo operator. I'll tell you what is modulo operator. This might be new for you or you may be aware. This is exponentiation. Every operator we are going to look at. Nothing to worry. See, first I am going to give 2 plus 5. 7. It is giving. Without variable, I am doing. Directly with a constant. Direct execution I'm trying to do. 2 minus 5, minus 3. 2 into 5, 10. Then 2 divided by 5, 0.4. Division. Division means you will be obtaining quotient after the division. Now I'm going to give modulo. Percentage symbol is modulo. It will give you remainder. Two remainder. Because it is, 2 is not divisible by 5. So 2 itself is the remainder. Now I will show other way around. 5 modulo operator 2. Look at now 1. What is the meaning? 2 2s are 4. Without decimal point, only 2 times we can divide 5. Then remainder would become 1. 5 modulo 2. The remainder would become 1. Now we are going for exponentiation. What is this double star is 5 to the power of 2. Answer would become 25 to the power of 2, the answer would become 25. See, look at, this is where I was trying to tell associativity. 2 into 2, 2 to the power of 2, to the power of 4. That is what I'm trying to tell. Here, the order of evaluation is important. If at all it does, right to left, 4 to the power of 2 to the power of 2 means different answer. 2 to the power of 2 to the power of 4 means different answer. It uses left to right associativity. Because of that left to right associativity, we are getting this answer. If it is right to left associativity, the answer will become different. This situation only, PEMDAS rule will not work. We need to move on to associativity. Every operator, even relational operator, logical operator, when it becomes equal priority, then second option is associativity. Remember all the time, whenever anyone asks what is the meaning of associativity, the power becomes same, then we need to apply interview panel. Remember, your interview panel, there are 5 people are sitting. One woman, if you try to focus on that woman, hi madam, good morning, if you don't focus on that female, male candidates, then they will think that this guy has bias. You should not do like that. You always either you need to greet them left to right order or right to left order. Then they will agree, they will understand your. Can we use division instead of percentage? No. Division has a purpose, question. That percentage has the purpose, reminder. That's what. If you put, once again I will show, insert above, insert below. I will use 5 divided by 2. Look at the answer, 2.5. Why it is 2.5? 2 times you can divide 5 without decimal. After if you put decimal, you can divide that remaining value 5 times, 2.5. Now I am going to give 5 remainder 2. Look at the answer, 1. What is the meaning is 2 into 2, 4. With the whole number, how many times you can do the division? Without that dot, applying dot, how many times you can do? Only 2 times. Then what is left out? 1 is left out. That 1 you will be getting. The previous case, what it is doing is, with that 1, it will add, try to add 1 0. Because after dot, you have the privilege. You need to go back to your childhood days. Especially first standard, second standard days. Then you need to use 0. Then it will become 10. 10 divided by 2, what is the meaning? 5. So that is why you are getting 2.5. Whereas here, you are not ready to use decimal. Then the moment you are not ready to use decimal, what is the remainder value, left out value? That left out value is displayed as the output of remainder operator. Hope so. Biswatch, you may be clear with this. That's it. This is called percentage operator. Now, I think Professor Ramesh, shall we stop at this junction and to question?
Ma'am?
Yeah, with the QA
it's
session.
Already 6 o'clock, right?
Pardon, sir?
It's already 6 o'clock.
Yeah.
Yeah. Tomorrow we may continue, ma'am.
Yeah, continue. We can take.
If any student having any doubt, they may raise the questions.
Yeah. If they have doubt, let us wait for 1 minute. If not, we close. If possible, let us generate Zoom link, sir, tomorrow.
Yes, yes.
Yes. Any other participants other than Synergy Institute of Technology, you may need to be in touch with us, sir. Is it possible? I will write down my mail ID. You can communicate for the change of, change of URL or software. If you use, we will be in touch. Because Zoom supports naturally.
Suman, Aniket, Asutos, if you're having any questions, please ask to ma'am. Asutos.
Yes, sir.
Rajeshri.
This is my mail.
Biswajit Das.
No down other than Synergy Institute of Technology.
Inmaya Kahu. Asutosh. Devapriya. Any kind of questions coming in your mind?
Sir, but really they are interactive. Many questions have come
yes,
in
yes.
itself.
Yeah. All are good students, ma'am.
Yeah, Google collaborates you are asking. I will try.
Fire.
Show. 1 minute, I'll do stop presenting.
सत्यरंजन पात्र,
यस सर,
सत्यरंजन आपन कौन डाउट हो पचारंतु।
नो सर, नो डाउट।
नो दिस प्रेजेंटेशन इज यू नो आई मीन्स यूजफुल फॉर यू नॉट
यस सर, यूजफुल।
मैम, लेट मी नो फर्स्ट हाउ मीन्स बिगनर कैन इंट्रोड्यूस और इम्प्लीमेंट दिस काइंड ऑफ सॉफ्टवेयरिंग इनटू सम काइंड ऑफ यू नो इनटू न्यू फॉर प्रोजेक्ट डेवलपमेंट्स, ड्रोन्स, रोबोटिक्स एंड व्हाट एल्स, वेयर वी कैन इम्प्लीमेंट पाइथन एंड स्टूडेंट कैन यूज फॉर प्रोजेक्ट डेवलपमेंट।
Professor, one person, Anushman Dash, asked for collaboratory demo. I changed my screen presentation. Now you can see my Google. Am I right? If I want to teach them Google collaboratory because they don't have laptop itself. Sir. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yeah. Could you see my Gmail, sir, now? Gmail.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Guys, please pay your attention. This 9 dots you need to click. After clicking the 9 dots, drive. This triangle drive you need to click. It will take us to another screen. 1 minute. I will stop present. Present now. Now I will open this. I need to do every time. Now you have come to Google Drive. In this Google Drive, look at new button. That new. Click the new button, go to more, hope so you all can able to see what I'm trying to do. Go to more, come here, Google Collaboratory, you can notice here. Or else just type in the Google Collaboratory, it will take you, that is another method. I use this method only. So come to, go to new, come to more, look at the yellow color icon will be there, Google Collaboratory. I'm clicking this. It will open a new tab. I will stop share and I will again present it. It is loading. White color. It looks white color. Please wait for a moment. You will see cells. Typically, yeah, it is loading. See, the Google Collaboratory is loaded. I am going to name this as Synergy or Mechanical. Name of the file is Mechanical. .ipynb, don't touch that, .ipynb, that is the extension of Google Collaboratory. See, it has to code or text. I am going to click text. The moment I click text, see, it is much more beautiful than Jupyter Notebook. I can bring my image, I can bring some website, I can decorate, hi guys, I am going to give hi guys, it's a Python introduction session. I'm typing. See, I can select these all. I can apply this bold and I can change the text color also. I can center, I can align indent block automatically here. Indentation is possible. See, it is showing. This is the power. You can explore these all. These are for annotation. Now, insert code cell. Immediately, I have come to code. Next cell. Here you type same code I am going to write. Age comma name comma city is equal to 55 comma John comma Orissa typing. Now what will happen? Age will receive 55, name will receive John, city will receive Orissa. Enter. Shift enter. Same. See, it is executing with that play button. You need to click that play button. Now let it stop. After that, I need to know what is the value available in age, what is the value available in name. Yeah, one has come. What is the one means? Only one time I have executed. Now I am going to press age. See, automatically age will come. Press this play button. In your mobile also you need to do. See, 55. Then insert code cell. I need to type name. Name, it has some name. Press the play button. Name. Name is John. That's all. Do coding as much as possible, whatever you want. Now city. I want to know what is the value available in city. Press the play button. Orissa. That's all. Whatever I have explained, The same you could do with you do here. What will happen if you write print of age? Yeah, print of age also will do print. Yeah, I will write. I haven't started the command. I'm just introducing today. See, print of age. I have written the command print of age. Print 55. That's it. Somebody have asked a question. Prashant asked a question. So print of age, working, yeah, that's it. So slowly I wanted to introduce, that's it. Better that you are curious to learn, you yourself raise this question, print of age. Required or not in string type, not required. See, I'm going to use complex print statement, I will introduce later. Right now, print of name. Shift enter I can give or I can play button, anything. Shift and enter you need to press. Or if you are using play mobile, no, you can't apply shift and enter. You just press that play button. Now, print of city. Automatically it gives that all supporting it will give. Press the place button, Orissa. Yeah, it doesn't matter what variable it is. You just use a variable, pass the variable within the print function. It does for you. Any other question? Within today's discussion, you please ask. Other thing, I will continue tomorrow. How to give input, all those things tomorrow, ma? Nothing to worry, because we need to end up the session already 6:15. My mobile power is only 20. Anything, anytime it may go. So let us wind up. Any question you have within today's context, you please ask. All other how to give input, complex print statement with the display, that all I will be sailing with you tomorrow and subsequent days. Nothing to worry. I will make you to feel comfortable with Python. But right now, like a co-laboratory, someone asked, demonstration has been given. You need to go to Gmail. That 9 dot would be there. That 9 dot you need to click. Then you need to click drive. Within the drive, top left, you need to click new. Within that new, you need to find out co-laboratory. Click that co-laboratory. Then you will come here. Save the file name. Like I saved like mechanical, you save whatever you want. Don't delete .ipynb. That is mandatory, that you should be careful. Then you type the code in every cell. Every cell, you can design what you wish. You can treat it as code or you can treat it as text. Text is for annotation. Code is for doing Python code. Then once you have written Python code, you need to press this play button. That play button will make you to play the code or execute the code. Then it will stop. After stopping, you can, if there is no error, it will give you answer. If there is an error, then it will give you error. Then you need to move on to the next step, subsequent. That's it. With that, we can conclude today's session. Anushman, tomorrow we are going to look at inputs, input data and input